Hey guys, so I'm gonna try something a little bit new tonight because the project I had planned on filming didn't really work out. I was gonna work on that keyboard that I mentioned during one of my earlier videos, but unfortunately I didn't get the right parts. Or rather, I did. They're just not compatible with the rest of the parts I have, so now I have to order more stuff and wait, yada yada. Anyway, for those who don't know what this is a cassette adapter, excuse me, I'm getting texts, for, you know, you got one end, plug it into your phone or your iPod, you know, if you're one of those weird people who still uses those like I am, and then you put the other bit inside your tape deck in your car and you can listen to whatever the hell tunes you want. I have already repaired this thing several times and it is broken again. And I'm at the point where if I actually have to pay for anything with my car, I'm just going to buy a new one. But if I can... out of context, I realize how that sounds. But if you knew what I drove and how much I've already put into it and the age of the vehicle, yada yada, the tape deck should be a little bit of an indication on that. But, you know, if I can get it fixed easily and cheaply, then by all means... Anyway, the problem with this thing is the cord absolutely sucks. As you can see, it has broken again, but that's not why I'm bothering to fix it this time. The problem is actually at the other end. This plug seems to short out intermittently and just drop connection, and I'm just going to go ahead and see if I can't replace it. So it comes apart, 5 screws, easy peasy. There's, like, nothing to this stupid thing. You can see the bodge I did last time. I just spliced the wires, taped it together, and then added some strain relief. But you can see how absolutely complicated these things are. Oh, I should turn on my soldering iron. And, quite frankly, they're not complicated at all. Yes, I am fully aware that there are mods for, just replacing the tape deck entirely, but that is a lot more work, and it's never gonna sound great anyway, so, you know, just gonna chase diminishing returns on that. But my goal is to be able to listen to whatever I want while I'm driving. Okay, so I'm just gonna snip this end off. So I don't even care anymore. Then I can slide this mess of insulation off. There we go. And this here is the donor. This is a expansion cable I bought from the usual scumbags. Female one end, male the other end. This thing doesn't work worth a damn, but I think that's because the gauge on the wire is entirely too small and the wire itself is entirely too long. So I'm hoping that if I cut that down, I can fix the problems that I have with it, and fix this thing at the same time. Two birds. But I'm just going to go ahead and measure out the same length. This cable started on my cassette adapter significantly longer, but I have since trimmed it down last time I fixed it, because it was too long for my use. But maybe this cool braided stuff will... maybe it'll handle the environment of sitting inside my car on hot days a little bit better. But, oh man, the gauge on this is a lot smaller than I thought. I mean, I knew it was bad, but apparently I had no idea. Holy shit. If this works at all, I'm going to be super impressed. Well, you can see that. By the way, I'm filming on a different phone tonight. I finally got the Xperia rooted and unlocked and whatnot. I'm trying that out for the first time, and instead of filming on the Sony, or on the Lumia, because I've actually been using the Lumia as my main device as of late, and I'm expecting several more texts, but just so we can compare, this I already consider stupid thin gauge, but this, it's on a whole nother level. I'm going to go ahead and splice this in here. For those of you who have never soldered this enamel wire, avoid it if at all possible. It's awful soldering this stuff. I'm just desoldering the ends of the wire that I clipped off. Maybe. Probably best to just clip this off entirely and solder straight to the sensor thingy, the head, rather. But that's more work than I'm willing to put into this stupid thing. If only I had three hands. Oh, framing, you fuck. I suppose this isn't strictly necessary. It'll just be a cleaner bodge. But it does save me the hassle of having to strip the enamel off those wires. Anyway, this is just a matter of match the color. God, this gauge is so thin. I should not use this wire. I'm going to anyway, because I am, I never make poor decisions. But anyway, the easiest way to strip the coating off these wires, because these are, even though they don't have any insulation that you can strip normally, they do have insulation in the form of epoxy. The easiest way to strip that is to just burn it off. It's probably a better way, but I don't know an easier way. Right. Ah, there's the text I was expecting. I'll be right back. Alright, that's sorted. So, in this case, I hope one or both of these are actually wired properly, and the colors have some sort of meaning, because if not, this might not work properly. But fuck it, we'll make it work, right? I'm just going to twist these together. Oh, this is not working at all. The wire I'm trying to solder on is entirely too thin. Right there goes that. fix that. And there goes that. That's dangerous. There we go. That's exactly what we want to do. Drop a big old blob of solder onto the reed head. Okay. I'm satisfied with that. I'm going to insulate with a Kapton. Maybe. There it goes. Doesn't have to be proper, because this is literally never going to be seen by anyone. I mean, aside from the fact that I'm documenting this and putting it on the internet. But I mean, if it works, I don't really care how janky it is. I just want to blast my hardcore gangster rap. Is that too much to ask for? Alright. Then I'm going to tape that down out of the way. Oh shoot, the strain relief tabs are all broken off. That's okay. That'll go like that. And I'm going to put that right over the screw hole, so that I have some extra support from the screw itself. All these gears and shit are in place. That's still where it needs to be. That's where it needs to be. Okay. Alright, so my car, 2005 model year, and yes, it does still have a tape deck. No, technically it didn't come with a tape deck, but I pulled that out of the same model out of junkyard for like 15 bucks and swapped it in. No need to make a harness adapter or anything, it just plugged right in. But if this works for my car, works for me. Got all the screws tightened, and just dropped my blade on me. That's okay, because I actually closed it this time. And we got a new cable on there, and it looks better too, even though it's super thin gauge. Hopefully it'll stand up to the heat a little bit better too, because the insulation on this one just tends to split. Of course, it's perfectly fine now, but whatever. Anyway, I'm gonna go test this out, and we'll see what happens.
We'll have to excuse all the background noise, but got that plugged in. Did I hit play? I did hit play. And it's working. So I'll take that. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a good night.